Dan Hans is here with the rest of the Around the NFL team. Boys, we're into the offseason. I know it's hard to believe that because nothing ever ends in the NFL. But as we spin forward looking ahead to 2017, let's talk about some of the offseason storylines to watch. Mark Sessler, you wrote a banger, but the storylines that we want to watch other than Tony Romo.
Yeah, I mean, I think we're going to be barraged with Tony Romo, so let's look at some other things. That was my thought.
All right, so then why don't we look at the backup quarterback of the New England Patriots, the Super Bowl champions, Jimmy Garoppolo. Gentlemen, I'll start with you, Chris Wessling. Where does Jimmy G end up?
I think he ends up in a bidding war with the 49ers, Browns, and Bears, and I think the Patriots get a windfall for him. This idea that they won't get a first-round pick, to me, is laughable. He was the best player on the field in his second career start when the Patriots waxed the Dolphins.
Who's peddling this idea that they're not going to get a lot for him? I mean, the Patriots don't even have to trade him if they didn't want to. They're going to demand a first-round pick. You think about the Browns' mid-first-round pick, that's a starting point. I think there's going to be multiple teams, as you said, that will give up more than that, maybe a first-round pick plus.
Well, and it's the top three teams in the first round that need Jimmy Garoppolo. And who does a better job of preying on desperate quarterback-free operations than Bill Belichick? I mean, and it's not about if you're in the AFC or the NFC. Way back in the day, he traded Drew Bledsoe to the Buffalo Bills. He doesn't care where it's going to happen. They're going to get great value.
Well, there's a difference. He thought Drew Bledsoe was at the wrong end of his career. They're not trading Jimmy G to your Jets. I think they like Jimmy G too much to trade it to a division rival.
All right, they traded Bledsoe because they thought he was on the wrong end. I hate to tell everybody, Tom Brady, even though it doesn't look like it, is on the wrong end because he's going to be 40
in August.
Is
he? I'm just saying. Peddling this one again.
I'm just saying, if you have a scenario, where you could be the 90s 49ers, if you really think Jimmy G is the real deal, when they went from Montana to Steve Young, the Patriots, in my mind, could be blowing an opportunity to have the next guy to take them into the next decade if Brady's done in a couple of years, which nobody believes it, but it could happen.
Tom Brady did not have Randy Moss this year. They took Rob Gronkowski away. He played better than ever, which means he's literally in his prime. The Patriots believe he has 3 to 5 more years left, according to Rap Sheet. There's a reason why they drafted Jacoby Brissett in the third round. Why keep all three of those guys when you can get a windfall for Garoppolo?
And this is an opportunity for New England. You're always picking at the end of the round, year after year. This is an opportunity to completely reshape your position in this draft. It doesn't come around that often.
I get the logic of it. It makes sense, especially if you can get a ton of materials back, players back, and draft picks, but at the same time, it is the most important position, and you have a successor.
I have bad news for you. Tom Brady is going to play until about 2026, Dan. I'm sorry.
That's the thing. That's the joke in all this. Everyone thinks that, but it's not going to happen. He's 40 years old.
But if he does
almost
play for 2 more years at this level, what are you going to do when Garoppolo is a free agent next year? You're going to get nothing for
him. Well, and why do you assume Garoppolo is going to be a better prospect than Brissett, who they love, who they drafted in the third round, who had great intangibles? Garoppolo's value, it's almost like that injury he had helped him out, because he played 6 great quarters. He played 6. You can't put a pin in those 6 quarters. I mean, he couldn't have done any more. You look at that Dolphins game, and people, would you be excited to get Jimmy G for the Cleveland Browns? Because to me, more exciting than Tony Romo or Jay Cutler or Mike Glennon or any of those guys.
I think so, too. And it's people say, oh, is this the next Brock Osweiler? I think it's a completely different player than Brock Osweiler. The caution is he's 25 years old.
Better
with
looking.
91 pass attempts, better looking than Brock Osweiler. But, I mean, it's a risk. It's a risk, but you got to go.
We haven't seen a lot from Jimmy, but what we have has been very good.
That's fair. We've seen poise. We've seen the ability to beat the blitz. He has as quick a release as any quarterback in the NFL, and he's got coaches in San Francisco and Cleveland who love him already.
Congratulations, Mark. He's going to be on the Browns in a couple months.
We'll see. We don't know.
Get that jersey ordered already.